Thank you. Gurudev will be here till the very end. There is a drama also after the katha by the Gurukul students from Badger. So please stay to watch that and encourage these young children. With that, I would like to ask Krishna Vallabhadasi from Alachua, Florida, for the bhajan. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. external and not in you. Please be merciful, Gurudev, to all of us. We all want this thing you are wanting to give us so bad. Make our hearts ready. Make our hearts so fertile that we can keep these things in our heart, not lose them when we're not with you.
Vishnu Padayo, Krishna Prasthayo, Bhutale, Shimate Bhakti Vedanta Sami, Iti Namine. ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिसे नमः। गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो नमः। तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमाम चरणान्तिके। यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरह कातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया सर्वोऽभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माय मिलियंस ऑफ दंडवत प्रणाम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय परमारथतम गुरु पाद पद्म नित्य लीला प्रविष्टों विष्णु पाद शिष्म भक्ति प्रज्ञान के स्वस्वामी एंड सेम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय शिक्षा गुरु नित्य लीला प्रविष्टों विष्णु पाद शिष्म भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज। वे यस्टरडे began to speak about Ras Leela and some part you have spoken, but one thing has been left. Indra is demigod. He has been given a duty for reign in this world. So once he forgot this and he thought that I am independent God. I am giving rain to world, so grasses are coming, cows and animals are eating, they are making milk, from milk so many things comes. Also water in ponds and rivers and everywhere. If I will stop rain, then all will die. He was thinking. Krishna knew this thing. Oh, he has forget. And he is thinking that I am an independent God. So I must crush his false ego. Then he one day in 1 year, Brajavasi used to do puja of Indra. Same day, Mother Yashoda and all gopis in Braja, they were engaged in making so many paraphernalia like puja, malpuja, puri, kachauri and so many things. Krishna went to his mother and told, Mother, why you are preparing so many things? Is my birthday today? Oh, you should go and play. I have no time to answer. Then he went to his father, Nanda Baba, and asked, Baba, I went to mother, but she told that, go on. He could not answer my question. So please answer and satisfy me. Who is Indra? And why you each year do his puja? And then he replied, oh, Indra is deep. God of rain. Without rain we cannot survive. cows give milk and all animals take it. Also in pond, rivers, everywhere fresh water comes. We drink and that is why we are alive. Without Indra we cannot be alive. So, today we will do puja of Indra. Then Krishna argued, discuss that where there is no puja of Indra, there rains, no rains or rains, everywhere rains. It is not due to Indra, but Govardhan, dense forest there and very high, so he checks clouds and then rain comes. And thus, he Govardhan, he is the main reason of the living cows and giving milk for us. So I think Indra is the not cause of rain, but Govardhan is the cause of. So we should try, we should do puja of Govardhan. Then a council of Upananda, Nanda, Sunanda and others were sitting and they decided that what this boy is telling, we should follow. He is telling, okay. And then they, what? After that, you.
Om Agyanatimirandasya Gyananjana Savakaya Chakshurannavitanyena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. First of all, I offer my most humble obeisances. Millions of times at the lotus feet of my Diksha Guru, Guru Parapadma, Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta, Swami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada. And again at the lotus feet, millions of times at the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. So Srila Gurudeva has ordered me to speak about this Govardhan Leela. So, Krishna, he wanted to curb the pride of Indra and he wanted to establish, just as he had spoken to his coward friends in order to establish that these Brahmins, these smarter Brahmins in Mathura, he wanted to curb their pride and make them understand that the worship of demigods through the Vedic ritualistic sacrifices were useless. Also, he wanted that this should be understood by all persons. So when he saw that his father was performing this yajna for Indra, so he wanted to make sure that all understood that I am to be worshipped, that everything should be offered to me, that those who worship the demigods, alpamedasha, they have small intelligence. And so in this way, after having this discussion with his father, and speaking in such a way that father, this is not necessary to perform this ritual. If you do your work, if you follow the four orders, and everyone does their duty according to Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Sudras, then all the results will come. No requirement for doing any kind of puja to Indra. Indra is not required. In this way, he made Indra very, very angry. Very, very angry. So, when the council gathered together, Maharaj Nanda, Upananda, Sunanda, etc., and they decided, they asked Krishna to give instructions. So you direct us, how should we perform this puja? Because initially they wanted to delay. They thought, oh, we'll do the puja now and then we'll do Govardhan later. Krishna said, no, no, don't do that, don't delay. Now everything what you have gathered for Indra, you will give it to Govardhan. So he said, you call the Brahmins, you have the Brahmins sing Vedic hymns and offer these hymns in glorification of the Govardhan. Then you bring all the cows and great green grasses should be fed sumptuously to all the cows. Then all of these great food stuffs which you have made with ghee and grains, puris, kachoris, halva, ladu, rasgulla, sandesh, sweet rice, everything, Table, rasmalai, oh. All these things we should offer them to Govardhan. Bring to the hill and offer them to the Govardhan hill. Because our connection is with Govardhan hill. Indra will pour rain on the ocean and he will pour rain on the hill. He's pouring rain everywhere. Why do we have to praise Indra? Anyway, rain will come. Just worship Govardhan hill. Everything is being provided there. That is our relationship with Govardhan hill. So, they began. All the gopis and gopis came. Gopis got decorated very nicely. Like Gauravani, she is wearing that nice bright pitambar and red color. Like this, they decorated themselves in nice outfits. Then they came on the bullock cart singing songs in praise of Krishna's pastimes. Then also they had all of the different persons bringing the different grasses and all of the foodstuffs and laying it before Govardhan hill. And then when everything was prepared, all the preparations were there in front of Govardhan hill, and all the prayers and sacrifices were going on, and suddenly Sri Krishna assumed a gigantic form, a huge form, and he began to consume all the prasadam. So in this way, Krishna showed all of the inhabitants of Vrindavan that he himself was Govardhan hill. And in this way, all the inhabitants of Vrindavan became very much pleased, very much happy to see how all the prasadam was being consumed by Krishna, how being consumed by Govardhan. And they became very pleased. Then, when this was going on, Indra could see that Krishna has robbed his share of the yajna, his share of the sacrifice has been robbed by him. So he became very angry. Actually, Indra is a demigod. He knows that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but he is thinking how this little boy is thinking that he is that person. He could not be Krishna. So, therefore, thinking that this little boy is just childish, puffed up, talkative, arrogant, he decided that he was going to teach him and all the inhabitants of Vrindavan a lesson for listening to this little boy. So he called the Samvartaka cloud. Samvartaka cloud is the huge cloud which comes at the end of the universal existence for devastation of the entire cosmic manifestation. A great flood comes and covers all the planetary systems. So that cloud was called. Many other clouds with ice, snow, heavy rains came. All the clouds were called, and Indra told, now I am going to punish these arrogant and foolish inhabitants of Vrindavan for not giving my share of sacrifice. I will punish them immediately. All of you shall go there, and I will come on my elephant Aravata with my thunderbolt weapon, and I will bring great torrents of rain, thunder, and lightning upon the inhabitants of Vrindavan. And speaking in this way, the clouds became actually frightened. They had an understanding that if we do this, Krishna will become angry at us. What will we do? They went, because Indra forced them. So all of them went, and the rain started to come. Torrents of rain. It says in the Bhagavad that the rains were like piercing arrows, sharp, falling upon the ground. And all the inhabitants of Vrindavan became very frightened, very disturbed. So, suddenly they all came running to Krishna. Look what is happening. All the lands are being filled up with water. We have no place to go. We have to take shelter of you. Please protect us. Please protect us. The cows came with their calves tucked up under their bodies, bowing their heads. The gopis, the gopas, Nanda, Yasoda, all came. Please help us. Please protect us. Krishna said, don't do it. Don't worry, I will rain everything. Then, little Krishna, he took his left hand. In India, to show that something is not very heavy to pick up, a person will use his left hand because that is supposed to be the weaker hand. So Krishna is trying to show Indra, this is not a very difficult thing. Srila Prabhupada used to say that Krishna taught Indra that your disturbance is the business of my little pinky.
So he took his pinky and just like this picked up the great Govardhan hill into the air. Then he told, come on Nanda Baba, Jasodamayi, all gopis, gopas, everyone you come underneath there. So they were a little bit nervous how this little boy is holding this big hill all by himself in the air. And no, don't worry, you all come. So they all came. They came with their bullock carts, their cows, all the thousands of inhabitants of Vrindavan, the millions of cows, bullock carts, everything. They all came and they all gathered around Krishna. And they stayed there underneath this hill for more than 1 week. For 1 week, they stayed under the hill. During that time, while Krishna was holding up this hill, so sometimes he was looking at all the inhabitants, and at one point, he was looking at the gopi, and he was looking at Radharani, and he became a little bit afflicted in his heart. And then he saw his brother looking at him, elder brother Balaram. Oh, Balaram sees that I am looking at Radha? Oh. Then he became a little nervous, and his hand trembled, so the hill started to tremble. Then all the gopas, Nanda Baba, Sunanda, Upananda, and Balaram, and Sridhar, and they go, okay, we'll help you, don't worry. They took their sticks like this. Okay, we'll help you, Krishna. We'll hold up this hill like this. So all were putting their sticks up in the air, holding, trying to help Krishna hold up the thing. So, after 1 week, all the rain, it something. Indra was looking. He was sending chunks of ice. He was sending pillars of rain, arrows of rain, lightning, thunder, everything. Then he saw Krishna. 1 week, Krishna is holding up this hill, and for 1 week, the inhabitants in Vrindavan are completely undisturbed. They are feeling no hunger, no thirst, no anxiety, nothing. Completely absorbed in Krishna, they have become cleansed, they have become free from all anxiety, everything. So in this way, Indra then realized, Then Krishna saw that all the rain has stopped, the water has receded, and gradually, very carefully, it says in the Srimad Bhagavat that he had all of the inhabitants of Vrindavan leave. They all left from underneath the hill. Everybody left. And then he replaced the hill in exactly the same spot that he picked it up from, without any loss or diminution, anything even showing. So then replacing the hill like this, then everyone became very happy. They all came and they approached Krishna. Nanda Baba, Yasodamayi, Rohini, Sunanda, Upananda all approached and embraced Krishna and smelled his head and rubbed his head. Then all his cowherd friends came and gopis in the background. They were all embracing Krishna within their hearts and all were singing the glories of Krishna and praising Krishna, how he has helped to protect them from the rains of Indra. Even the siddhas, charanas, all Gandharvas, everyone there came, blowing conch shells and trumpets, playing tampuras, raining flowers upon the earth, and glorifying with songs and dances, glorifying the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna and how he protected the inhabitants of Vrindavan. So while Krishna was standing there and this big ceremony of praise and glorification was going on, he went off into the side. And then from behind the tree, Indra came, and the Sarabi cow from Goloka came. And as the Sarabi cow poured transcendental milk upon the head of Sri Krishna, and then Aravata, the elephant of Indra, came, pouring Ganges water upon Indra. Indra came and laid prostrate in front of Krishna with his big, gorgeous, effulgent crown full of jewels, placed it at the feet of Krishna and begged for his forgiveness, begging him that I have committed a great aparadha, a great mistake. I have not understood that you are actually that Supreme Personality of Godhead who is my Lord and Master. I have thought that you are just some impudent child that you have tried to steal all of my share of the yajna, but now I understand who you are. I understand that you have done this to help reduce my pride, my arrogance, and I am very grateful to you for your mercy in this regard. And so Indra was very, very repentant, and Airavata then putting the Ganges water upon his head, the Saravi cow putting the milk from the loka upon the head of Krishna, and the earth was completely restored. The floods had resided, the plants, the trees, the creepers, the flowers, the grasses, the grains, the fruits, the vegetables, everything began to manifest in great abundance all around Govardhan Hill and all over Govardhan Hill. And no detection of the flood or the rains was even seen. It was completely restored to its original beauty and opulence. And in this way, Krishna showed how in his presence, everything is all auspicious. This is a story of Deirdre.
कृष्ण की इच्छा अनुसार ब्रजवासियों ने पहले गौओं की पूजा की, उन्हें हरी हरी घास खिलाई, गौओं की चरणों की पूजा की, पानी दिया और हल्दी और घी से मिला हुआ वो हाथ का पंजा उनमें चारों तरफ में लगा दिया। सिंह में भी बड़ी सुंदर सुंदर तेल लगा करके बहुत सुंदर उनको बनाया, और इसके बाद में ब्राह्मणों को और भक्त लोग, वैष्णव लोग जैसे शांडिल्य ऋषि इत्यादि सबको बुला करके उनकी पूजा की। पहले गौओं की, तब वैष्णवों की और भक्तों की पूजा करके तब गिरिराज जी की पूजा आरंभ की। जब कृष्ण को निवेदन किया तब कृष्ण अपने एक स्वरूप में कृष्ण रूप में रह करके और दूसरे चतुर वहां पर गोवर्धन के ऊपर बहुत बड़ा विशाल रूप धारण किया और बोले आनो रे और ले आओ। उन्होंने एक क्षण के अंदर में सब कुछ खा लिया और पावन सरोवर का, कुसुम सरोवर का, मानसी गंगा का सब पानी भी पूरा पी लिया। कुछ रहा नहीं, कुछ भी नहीं रहा। जब और मांगने लगे तो कृष्ण ने कहा जे हे प्रभु, हम लोग गरीब ब्रजवासी हैं, हमारे पास और कुछ नहीं है, आप इसी से संतुष्ट हो जाइए। कहने के बाद में जो कुछ पहले जैसा था सब पूरा फिर भर गया, जैसे जैसे था पूरा हो गया फिर। और गोवर्धन जी ने कहा जब वर मांगो, सब ब्रजवासियों ने वर मांगा कि कृष्ण निर्विघ्न रहे और सुखी रहे, बस कृष्ण के लिए ही उन्होंने सर्वस्व मांगा। जब कृष्ण ने गोवर्धन पर बल उठाया कनिष्ठ से, कनुष्ट माने कृष्ण शक्तिमान है, शक्ति तो राधा जी है और वो बाएं तट पर रहती है पुरुष के, तो कृष्ण ने जो वो गोवर्धन उठाया वो असल में राधा जी ने उठाया। कृष्ण तो इच्छा थी और राधा जी ने उठा दिया, और जितनी गोपियां थी दृष्टि से गोवर्धन को रोक लिया। कृष्ण के ऊपर में कुछ भार नहीं, यदि नीचे तुम गिरेगा तो जला करके भस्म कर देंगे उनको, इसी प्रकार से रुक करके रखा। उस समय में पहली बार अब गोपियां नौजवती होकर हो गई हैं, वो कृष्ण के सामने ब्रजवासियों के सामने भी निकट आई और बड़े प्रेम से कृष्ण की तरफ में पहली बार निकट से देखा। ये उसकी विशेषता है। अब कल हम लोगों ने बतलाया था और ट्रांसलेट
चंद्रराधिका कृष्ण कृष्ण भक्त तदवर्ता नमो नमः।
Before the Giriraj Puja, first was the worship of the cows. First, Krishna and the Brijvasis fed the cows green grass. Then with oil mixed with haldi, turmeric, they decorated the cows with handprints. Then afterwards, the Brijvasis worshipped and fed the Brahmanas and the Vaishnavas. And then they worshipped Giriraj by offering him all the thousands of items they had prepared. Giriraj took a huge form, and in 1 second he ate everything, crying, Anayor, Anayor. That time he also drank all the water from the different kunds like Pavan Sarova, Man Sarova, Manasi Ganga. In 1 second everything was finished. But still he was crying, bring more. Then Krishna went before him, O Giriraj, you are so massive and we are simply poor Brijvasis. Please be satisfied by our seva. That time, in 1 second, all the prasadam returned as it was. Then Giriraj offered choose a benediction. All the Brijvasis asked, we only want one thing. May Krishna be happy. May his life be without any obstacles. So Krishna, he lifted Govardhan by his left hand. Why? Because he is Shaktiman, the possessor of potencies. And therefore, Shakti always resides, comes from the left side of the Lord. Therefore, Krishna, by lifting Govardhan with his left hand, he indicated, I am not lifting Govardhan, my Shakti or Srimati Radhika, she is lifting Govardhan. Why? Because Krishna can only desire, but his energy fulfills his desire. Therefore, Krishna desired to lift Govardhan, but Radharani actually lifted. That time the gopis were also glancing at Govardhan. Giriraj, if you fall from the sky, we will burn you to ashes by our glance. Therefore, out of fear of the gopis, the Govardhan remained in the sky. One more speciality of this pastime, the speciality of Giriraj Govardhan Dhanam. Giriraj Maharaj Ki!